to be a little more than what it was, but you know, we will accept the win for the way it is. With the court actually stating that someone or the courts cannot tell us what our religion is and what we do with our religion, that's one of the positive things that has come out of that, because this particular ruling, Alito made sure that they stated that. So it is for closed net organizations only, and I'm sure that Becca Fun told you that, because we're not lawyers or litigators, but it is for the closed net organizations. But now RFRA, it wasn't for RFRA, which was signed by a Democrat president. I don't know if you know that, that's actually signed by President Clinton. A Democrat president, if it wasn't for RFRA, we may have struggled with this win. But law changes in the court, all changes in the court, actually listening to the opinion being read, and then I was first in line for the actual opinion itself to bring it out so that they could see it and actually see what was where. But it was very good. It's a lengthy opinion given, but we think it's a win for us. I think it's a win for what they went in for, what they wanted, and I think that they got a perfect result there.
Well, we certainly celebrate with you folks there. As I mention on this show quite often, on this prayer line as well as on this television show, I get to go to Washington once a month, sometimes twice a month. But you folks are missionaries on the ground every day. You're in that Supreme Court every opportunity you get. And we thank you for being our missionaries from a spiritual perspective, as well as a legal perspective and a representative perspective there on Capitol Hill. Peggy, tell our listening audience, if they would like to get in touch with you, with Rob, with Paul, or any of your organization, tell them exactly how to do that, please. Well, if you go to the Wiley Drake Show archive, you will see one of your real good friends, Pat Mahoney, was here. We just left Hobby Lobby, Anaheim Hills. We had more than 100 people there, young people, celebrating this victory. And we celebrate not only with them, with survivors, Reverend Pat Mahoney, but also with Faith in Action, folks, because this has all been very much a part of what's going on. This is religious freedom in its truest sense. And ladies and gentlemen, as I said, Faith and Action are folk that do really believe that. That's not just their name. They do believe in faith. They are a people of faith, but they are a very strong people of action. In fact, the matter is, many of you have heard me broadcasting from Washington, D.C. many times when I'm in the Capitol, and I don't always advertise it too much, but many, many times, most of the times when I'm doing a live show, I need to get somewhere to do a live show, and their office is just down the street, and they have been very gracious to me because I'm a roving missionary there one day or two at a time, but they have been very gracious, and thank you for doing that for us. And ladies and gentlemen, go to their website. I want Peggy to give it one more time so you can write it down and so you can find out more about them. Go ahead and give it again.
Well, thank you so much. God bless you for coming on with us today. Now,
I don't know what your schedule is tonight, but as you know, we do another show tonight at 8 o'clock, your time, 8 p.m. And if you get an opportunity, call back in again. We'll still be celebrating. We'll have others on with us as well. But we'll have almost a different audience tonight. So if at 8 o'clock, between 8 and 9, you can call in and give us another report if you can, or have someone else do it as well. God bless you. Let me give you the last word. Anything else you'd say in reference to this 5-4 decision, in reference to faith in action, and in reference to our religious freedom in America? Go ahead. Well, thank you so much for that, and thank you for all that you guys do there on the Hill, in the courts, on the street, and even now with Pat Mahoney out here in Anaheim Hills, California, and with us, and we praise the Lord for all that you guys are doing. Please give Rob and Paul our love, and we'll see you the next time we're in D.C. God bless you. Keep up the good work, and goodbye.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bob, are you still there? Hello, are you there? Do we have a caller on the line? Yeah, Tony, how you doing, brother? We had a great victory today. And we're getting a lot of feedback for some reason. It may be because I'm in the car, but what's on your mind, Tony? Yes, I'm very familiar with them. In fact, one of the attorneys that was there, he's a judge now, Gary Creep, was my attorney against Obama. Well, they're a great group. In fact, Tony, I'm mobile right now. I'm in our vehicle doing a live broadcast. If you could call back tonight on the show, we'll be a little bit more easy to work because I'll be in the studio, and that will be at 8 o'clock Waynesboro time. We'll be back on, and so come back on then if you would, please. Yeah, you just come on the same line. That's fine. Okay, Tony. Thank you so much. God bless. All right, brother. God bless. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that was Tony Wright. Tony is a prayer warrior, comes on the prayer line with us almost every day. In fact, he has been on the prayer line, and as many of you know, we have changed the title of the prayer line. The title of the prayer line, starting back in 2000, was Telephonic Prayer Meeting, and I still use that sometimes because we are telephonic. We do pray and we do meet. But we recently, because of our involvement with many other organizations, such as Faith in Action, such as other organizations that we work with. We wanted to sort of hyphenate the name Telephonic Prayer Meeting and call it Telephonic Prayer Meeting hyphen Communications Channel. We want this system to be a communications channel. We saw these young people today communicate to the whole world about religious freedom, and that's what we're all about. We are here also to allow you to communicate. We do not, as you noticed, Tony called in just now, and we didn't really have a real good audio connection with him, and I didn't tell him to get off. I just said, come back on at 8. We'll not be in the vehicle then. At least I don't think we will be, but we'll be able to do a little better job. So we do not screen our calls. That's why this phone number is very, very important for you. The communications channel is reached by dialing a phone number, and putting in your access code, and then you will be live on the air with us. Now, you can also call me on my cell phone, because my cell phone is always open every time we're on the air. Not only is the communications channel open, but my cell phone is open. You can reach me by calling 714-865-8132 and join us here on the Wiley Drake Show as well. Ladies and gentlemen, we are mobile this morning. Do we have another caller? Caller, are you there? Well, did you call on the cell phone now? That's okay. Well, you can call on either one, but ladies and gentlemen, today is a celebration day. We just celebrated with more than 100 young people out in front of Hobby Lobby, a 5-4 decision for religious freedom. Brother Bob, I believe you were going to share a song with us, but before you do we have another caller on the line? Okay, well, just hold on right now. I'm going to have another Bob on. Bob Bosworth is going to sing for Bobby Bible and for Wiley Drake and the rest of our audience. So, Brother Bob, sing the song, please.
Well, I wanted to sing a song that would bless our nation and what the Supreme Court has done. I think they're finally getting it.
Bob, amen. Amen. Amen.
Yeah,
I said this morning we celebrate a DOA, death on arrival, because part of the Obamacare that my dear friend down in Branson, Missouri, wrote about in the song when he said, Obamacare, it is scary for a health care plan to be something that kills babies and that kills old people. And that's what the Obamacare does. And we're 100% against that. And we thank God for this victory and a part, at least, of the Obama plan died today on Capitol Hill, and we celebrate that death on Capitol Hill.
Well, Pastor, I want to ask you a question. Did Pat Mahoney, is he in the car there with you, or did he come to the church?
No, he was out at Hobby Lobby. They had about 10, 15 passenger vans to haul all these young people around, and they did a great job there. And they're going to another Hobby Lobby. Basically, their plan today is to go to different Hobby Lobbies and rally the troops, so to speak, and celebrate this great religious victory in the United States of America. And I thank you for singing God Bless America. What a great song and a great tradition that is. But, you know, I've said we have a tradition in this country of politicians ending their statement by saying, and God bless America. And I think we need to get to a point to where we're changing that to say, and America bless God. Because we need to bless God. Hobby Lobby has blessed God. And God has indeed blessed them. Hobby Lobby, I don't know how many years they've been in business, but on the front door of the Hobby Lobby where we were at, we showed it on television, was a sign that said, store hours, Monday through Saturday, 9 to 5. Sundays closed so our employees can be with family and worship together. And they've had that for a long time before they ever got in this legal bind. So they are indeed a godly company and a great company, and we rejoice in this victory for them.
Well, I don't remember the man's name, but he was here at First Baptist Woodstock this last Sunday and received an applause of about 8,000, maybe 10,000 people. We had one combined service today. The auditorium was completely packed.
Amen. Well, praise the Lord for that. Brother Bobby Bible, are you still there?
Yes.
Any comments you'd like to make? What do you think about this victory we won?
Yeah, I'm
clear.
And I want to encourage us all to make sure we get our terminology straight on the murder of babies and abortion. Talk about it is me, the sex eunuch, and the Catholic priest. And the Catholic
All right, Brother Bobby, thank you. Brother Bob, thank you. We're going to shift. We're going to get out of the car, so I'll be off camera for just a few seconds. And then my new photographer, Rebecca, is going to open the door and continue to film us. And we're going to show you where Bobby Bible preached from yesterday. So, Rebecca, if you'll step out and continue the show here, we still have a show to do. And she's going to come out and she's going to film this. We're now, ladies and gentlemen, at 6801 Western Avenue. And I'm going to walk over here to the sidewalk. And this is where the man that's on the phone with me, Bobby Bible, this is where he preached yesterday, right here on this sidewalk, with his banner and with what God told him to say. And inside that building is where I preach. And then out here, I want to ask if you would, to just sort of pan, you can see the cross and the area where we yesterday had our call to fall. And right here, where these marks are on the grass, we had a trailer parked here. And that trailer was nothing more than a trailer with a tank on it and steps, where we could walk up into the steps and have the person walk down into the water. And we performed 9 baptismal services yesterday. And so we thank the Lord for that. And Bobby, did you recuperate from your trip over here? Did we lose Bobby? Bob, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay, well, Okay. Well, thank you so much for listening and being a part of the show today. Tell you what we're going to do. We're going to go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and take the camera back and shoot a little footage, and then we'll be going off. All right. Thank you, Rebecca, for being my camera person. Go ahead, Bob.
I'm wondering if you've lost a little weight. You're looking very good. You're a very active man for your age, obviously.
Well, I did lose a little weight. In fact, lost a lot of weight. I've been under 200 pounds for the first time in many, many years. And I'm well under it. I'm about 190. So praise be to God. I feel a lot better. Yeah, that was Rebecca. You saw, this is Rebecca. She's the daughter. Which daughter? How many sisters do you have?
Four sisters.
Four sisters and
two brothers.
So there's seven.
To the
and you're second to the youngest.
Correct.
All right. And she was out with me this morning at 4:30 in the morning. The pastor's reputation may be in trouble because I was seen with a beautiful young woman at 4:30 in the morning, just me and her in the car.
And Jesus.
And Jesus, of course. Amen. But anyway, that's the hitchhiker's daughter, and we thank the Lord for her. She is such a great help here, and we appreciate it. And now, folks, I'm going to do a little footage here. You'll see the signs here. These are two churches that we allow the privilege to meet here at our church. And this gentleman coming here, come here and be on television with us. This, folks, is my good friend, what's his name? Charlie Harrison. And Charlie's been working several days to put this thing together that we just did. Charlie, say good morning to our audience.
Good morning, good morning.
All right.
And everything. God bless you.
Amen.
God be with you.
Amen.
And stuff.
Amen. Very good. Well, thank you for putting things back together and getting it ready to... Yeah, he had to put it up, then he had to tear it down.
That's right. Anything for Dr. Wiley Drake.
All right. Thank you so much. God bless you, Charlie.
And God bless you too, Wiley.
Thank you, brother.
I'm glad to be a part of it.
Well, thank you for being a part. Ladies and gentlemen, here are the two signs for two other churches that meet here, and we praise God for that. One Spanish, one Korean, and around on the other side, I'll not go there, there is another sign that talks about a Nigerian fellowship. And then we have a second Hispanic fellowship that meets in that building. They're going to be putting their banner up a little later as well. Well, it is going to be almost time for my show to be over, but I'm going to go off early today. Brother Bob, anything else you'd like to share?
What are the Ten Commandments supposed to benefit the church?
I beg your pardon?
Is that the area where the flag is?
Let me just walk over there, and I'll show you. It's there. The Ten Commandments monument are right in front of the flag. We, of course, carry Old Glory on the flagpole, and down on the lower part of the flagpole is the Israeli flag, which we're very proud of to be supportive of Israel. And right behind those Ten Commandments is a large boulder, a rock, with a photograph of my dear wife, Barbara, and that photograph is of her, and it gives her birth date and death date. In fact, the matter is, I'm going to make my way over here. Since we've got some more time, I'm going to be walking, so the camera may be jiggling a little bit, but we do encourage you to be patient with us. What I'm going to do is go in the side here, and you'll see the flagpole with the Israeli flag, and you'll also see what we call the Barbara Drake Memorial Prayer Cross, because my dear wife was a dedicated prayer warrior, and as a prayer warrior, we dedicated, after she went home to be with the Lord, she went home to be with our Lord and Savior, and my friend, Brother Will Ruffin, and others recommended, and my undertaker friend recommended that we get this large stone here. And if you get a look at this, you'll see that stone has a picture of Barbara on it. It has her February 26, 1944 birth date, and then her October 23rd, 2010 departure date when she went to be with the Lord. And then directly behind it is the cross. And the man just so happens, just walked up, Brother Will Ruffin, and he's here. He built this cross and another one that's at my home. And this area with the bales of hay is where we do Shabbat Shalom. And this, of course, over there is where we had the meal yesterday. We had all the events set up out here. And we had the stage over there. And so we thank the Lord for this opportunity.
Say hello to Will. I wanted to ask you, Pastor.
Hey, Brother Bob.
What are you going to do? Are you going to have the show on July 4th? Do you have anything specially planned?
Yeah, I'll be in Gettysburg, Pennsylvania, with my pastor, James David Manning. And we'll be celebrating the 4th at the Gettysburg Battlefield, where more than 25,000 men died trying to bring about racial reconciliation over slavery. So we'll be there on that battlefield on July the 4th. We will be doing live broadcasts from there. So praise God for that.
I want to send a praise out.
Okay. Now, I'm going to, Will said he has something to say.
I want to send a praise out for another victory for Jesus, for Hobby Lobby.
Amen.
For what the Supreme Court did today.
Amen. We just came from Hobby Lobby, had over 100 young people there.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. They're going to another Hobby Lobby. They're going to several Hobby Lobbies around to celebrate with Hobby Lobby in their parking lot. So to God
victory
be the glory.
For Jesus.
Victory. Another victory for Jesus and the good guys.
Amen.
Amen. Well, folks, I'm running out of voice here. I'm going to go ahead and go. We are back at the property here, And I want to say thank you again to Rebecca for going with me. And by the way, if you're ever in Southern California, just up the street from Knott's Berry Farm, in fact, from right here, sometimes if you listen real close, you'll hear the train whistle that Walter Knott had on that old steam locomotive down there at Knott's Berry Farm. And this is where we do Shabbat Shalom. If you're ever in this area, just look at the sun. If it's sundown, you can come here and celebrate the beginning of Shabbat on Friday at sundown and celebrate the ending of Shabbat on Saturday at sundown. So to God be the glory. Great things He's done. We want to say thank you, Jesus, for another victory for Jesus and the good guy. With that in mind, we're going to say good day. We'll be back at 5.